of rollout of GST, he had said, and I quote, India will be an India. It will be an India, sorry, it will be an India where the center and states will work harmoniously towards the common goal of shared prosperity. The unanimity of the constitutional amendment and the consensus of the GST Council highlights that India can rise above narrow politics for the nation's interest. With the GST, neither the state nor the center loses its sovereignty. In contrast, they will pool their sovereignty on decisions on indirect taxes, unquote. True to this vision for the historic structural reform, the goods and services tax has been gradually maturing into a tax that has integrated the country economically. It has consolidated numerous taxes and cesses to one tax and facilitated formalization of the economy. It has resulted in the efficiency gains in logistic and transport sectors. The turnaround time for trucks has witnessed a substantial reduction to the tune of 20% due to abolition of checkposts in the GST. The dreaded Inspector Raj has also vanished. It has also led to a significant benefit to MSME by way of enhanced threshold and composition limit. The effective tax incidence on almost every commodity came down substantially. Through several rate reductions, an annual benefit of 1 lakh crore rupees has been extended to consumers. It amounts to 10% reduction in overall tax incidence.